Hi, my name is Clayton Mero with Mason Bees for Sale. Today we're just going to talk briefly about the releasing of your bees and when to release them and how to set up your bee house. So for the last little while you've had your bees and the crisper in your fridge. What you want to do now is watch the temperature. That's your main indicator. You need to have at least the temperature be around 55 degrees Fahrenheit, and you need to make sure that you're not going to have periods of rainy days. Like about 10 days if you were to have your bees come out and then you had 10 days of heavy rainfall and colder weather below 55, it'll kill your bees and you won't get any pollination from them this year, or you won't be able to harvest their offspring for the next year. So first thing first, make sure the temperatures are warmer. Second thing, you want to check your blossoms on whatever type of fruit tree you're trying to pollinate, whether it's cherry, almonds, apples, apricots, that kind of thing. Once they start getting ready to come out, to turn into blossom, you want to get your bees out ready to go and the temperature's right. So what you do is you go into your fridge, get your bees out, and there's a couple different ways that we can talk about. We're just going to talk about two today, how to release the bee, simple ones. Now let's say you ordered a bee house with the reeds or just the bundle of reeds. This will work out great. So what you do is you take the bee, and we're going to zoom in here for you. And it's pretty obvious on the bee itself, if you look at one end, it'll have a nipple. And the other end will just be round. What you want to do is look at that nipple. That's the head of the bee, and that's the direction you want it to have when it comes out. So you want to take that nipple, and it wants to be pointing out. So what you're going to do is take the bee, and you're going to slide it inside of a reed like this and push it in, and maybe just slide it in about an inch or two with a pencil or something small that won't hurt the bee, and just push it back in there. Now, once you've done that, something really critical to do is you don't want to mix your males and your females together. The reason why is in nature, the bees, when they use the reeds, the bee will lay the females at the back and the males at the front. The reason why is the males will come out first and then the females will come out later. So if you were to mix that up and put the males in the back and the females in the front, when the males come out, what they'll do is they'll eat their way out and they'll eat through the females and kill them on their way out. And it'll just destroy all your female bees, which do your pollination, and you won't get any pollination or any offspring. So when you do this type of release, just put the, don't mix and match, either just put two or three or one male in one tube, and then two or three or one female in a tube, and just keep them separated like that. If you have smaller quantities, you can just put one in each hole and slide them back in. And they'll come out naturally on their own, that kind of stuff. The other option is, this is another one you can do. Let's say you just have cocoons. This is a piece of PVC pipe. It's about 3/4 of an inch around inside. You can cut them anywhere from 6 to 12 inches. Depending on the amount of bees you're going to release, you want a larger area. And the same thing goes with this. Don't mix and match your bees together. All males in one, all females in the other. And what you're going to do is when you buy, set up your thing, just go buy a piece of PVC pipe, two end caps, and cut it to the length you want, and then take your cap and slide one cap on. Don't use any glue, anything to that effect. And then the other one, you're going to drill a hole either 5/16 or 3/8 of an inch. And before you put this one on, you're going to take your cocoons and you're going to slide them inside of this, like this. Then slide your other cap on and just kind of shake them so they're just kind of in the middle right here. Then what you want to do is position this next to either your bee house or your reeds or something to that effect. Make sure it's laying flat like this. Don't stand it straight up and down like this. We've had people do this in the past. What happens is the bees will emerge down here at the bottom, and they'll kind of just walk around here at the bottom, and they'll never be able to get to where they can fly. So they'll never fly up out of the hole, and they'll just die here at the bottom, and you wasted your bees. So just kind of put them flat like this, like a bee house. You can hook them up someplace where they won't get too much rain or anything like that. Like this, put two holes on the side and just kind of screw them in before you put the cocoons in. That way you don't kill them with screwing them in. And all you got to do is just set it up so they'll come out. And the next critical thing is how do you set up your bee house or your bundle of reeds. And what you want to do, there's a few important things. First of all, make sure wherever you put it, it's in a secure place so the bee house won't wiggle or shake in the wind or move. Also, once you set it up, don't move it. Once it's set up, leave it for the season. You want to face it so these holes are facing south, southeast. You have that 90 degree angle that you can put the bees, that way they get the first rays of light, because the bee's cold-blooded and needs the sun to warm up. And pretty much that's about it. With your bundle of reeds, what you want to do is bundle them together, either with rubber bands or baling wire or something, and you need to cover the back of them with a piece of aluminum foil and then wrap duct tape around the end of them. It's just this back half needs to be covered. It gives a more realistic feel for the bee when it's in comparison to in nature when they're drilling into dead trees or using the beetle holes. It's dark, so somehow those need to be a little bit darkened towards the back. That's what makes it nice about the little bee houses. You can just slide the reeds in there and cinch them up a little tight that way they don't fall out. Also, when you put them up, make sure you, like on loose reeds like this, tip them down slightly. That way rain and moisture and wind stuff don't get inside of them. If you just kind of lay them flat or kind of up at an angle, water will run down and it'll kill your bees. Your bee houses are set up already to protect them and that kind of thing. Just kind of set them up against a flat area and you should be good to go. Hopefully that'll help you get going for this season to set up stuff. Once you set up everything, don't touch it, don't move it, and you should be good to go until about July, end of July. You can take down your bee houses and put them in a safer spot and store them until next spring, and then just repeat the same process that you've just done for this spring. Thanks.